Today it is lecture number 42. So we will talk about Markov, one special of process, Markov process, that we are calling it Markov chain. So we will study about Markov chain in detail in this lecture, and that would be summary of this. Many things we will see it here. So before going to that, in last class we were discussing about Poisson process. I will talk about few more property of Poisson process. Generally, Poisson process, it models arrival process. Also, that arrival process, you can say that it is a counting process. Why? Because you are counting number of people in a particular given interval. So that's why you can call that arrival process a special name, counting process. So all those are arrival process, counting process, all those are same name, similar kind of process. In arrival also you are counting people, counting customer, counting various things, counting success and counting failure, whatever you want to count, you are counting. So that's why you can call that those arrival process. If counting happens finite in sense, then you can simply say that arrival process happens to be counting process as well. And more general kind of things you can go to discuss about queuing process. So for queuing process you need to know what is the Markov process. So here in both Bernoulli process and Poisson process we had seen two interesting property. One property we are calling it independent increment, and another we are calling it a stationary increment. So those things again I will recall it like this way. So an arrival process has independent increment if the number of arrival in non-overlapping disjoint interval are independent. Like so, defining various interval, this non-overlapping interval like this way, like all these are. So call this one T1 and T2. This sub-interval is T1 and T2. So the complete interval 0 to T you have divided into sub-interval T1 to T2, T2 to T3, like this way. So if you try to observe number of arrival in this sub-interval Y, then what is happening that there is independency in the Poisson process. So in that process, in the Poisson process, we can say that there is an independent increment of number of arrival in the in these sub intervals, in the non-overlapping intervals. Okay, and hence we can say that further in term of random variable, incremental random variable. These are incremental random variable. So these incremental random variable happen to be independent to each other. The meaning of independent increment and independence of these incremental random variable happens to be equivalent. So one example I can take it, because why these conditions are helping to calculate probability of associated event, whatever we are going to calculate. So suppose we are taking an arrival process, or you can say that counting process or Poisson process, and we have a question that we have to find the probability of having two arrival in the interval 1, 2, and three arrival in the interval 3, 5. So you can say that you are talking about joint occurrence of arrival in two different non-overlapping event interval. So one interval happens to be 1 to 2, another interval is 3 to 5. So this one is 1 to 2, another is 3 to 5. So how can you find probability of number of arrival in these two intervals? So in interval, first interval 1 to 2, there are arrival. How many arrival? 2 arrival we observe. And how many arrival we observe in interval from 3 to 5? We observe 3 arrival. So what is the probability of arrival, joint arrival of these customer or whatever success, these arrival? What is the joint probability? So it is very easy to calculate this joint probability, that joint probability of arrival, 2 arrival in interval 1, 2 and 3 arrival in the interval 3, 5. How we can calculate? Just we know that due to this independent increment property, we can say that this joint probability is just product of probability of 2 arrival in the first interval 1 to 2 into probability of 3 arrival in the second interval 3 to 5. So it is very easy to calculate. This probability is very easy to calculate, and this also, you know, this one is also very easy to calculate thanks to Poisson random variable. Through that we can calculate, and easily we will get the value. I have already taken a problem later, you will see that. Another property I will talk about, that talking in Poisson process, that one is a stationary property, a stationary increment. What does it talk about? Say arrival, so an arrival process, it is having a stationary property. If you are taking any two time instant T1 and T2, and T2 is incremental greater than T1, and we can say that this incremented random variable x t2 minus x of t2 minus x of t1 it is having the same distribution of this single random variable with single argument t2 minus t1. So here we observe two different time. Here we are talking about different. So it is simply saying that the Poisson process is just dealing with the length of the interval. It is not worrying about what is the time instant. So Poisson process always focus on length of the interval. So that is that t2 minus t1 is the length of the interval. Interval of the time interval from t1 to t2. So you can say that this if Poisson a process which is satisfying that this incremental is just having the same distribution what this random variable with respect to length of the interval, then we can say that the corresponding random process happens to be a stationary having a stationary increment. Or simply we can say that if we either take this one this increment or we can what we do we are taking an interval of the same length, just we do right shift or left shift of the interval. That means we are taking an interval, suppose length of this one is t2 minus t1, and after simply give attention that it is not worrying about position, shift it to somewhere else by adding a time r, then it will come. So this point would be t1 t1 plus r minus sorry t2 plus r okay minus t1 plus r r will cancel out, length would be same but length that is this interval is having. Okay, there is no issue. So there is no issue. So that's why this one is calling about the stationary increment property. And here this increment and this increment, it would have same distribution. Why? Because both are having length of interval same. So that's why. So due to that, how we can define the Poisson process? Now I am giving one systematic definition of Poisson process. What does it talk about? Say a arrival process xt, where t is taking any finite time, positive time, we will call that arrival process a Poisson process with a rate lambda if the following property holds. First one, at zero time or zero time, there is no arrival. It is not possible. So that's why we are taking this assumption. So x of 0 equal to 0, xt has independent and stationary increment. That means this arrival process satisfying both property. Independent increment and a stationary property. Okay, apart from that, and the number of arrival in any interval of length has Poisson distribution. And what is the parameter of that Poisson distribution? We know that in last class I had already recalled the Poisson distribution, Poisson random variable. So in every interval of length tau will have a Poisson distribution with a parameter lambda time tau. So lambda time tau is the parameter of the Poisson distribution for a Poisson process. So this is the modified definition of Poisson process, we can call it like that. So I will take one example. Example is that we are talking about arrival process at a grocery. So grocery every in modern day, I am talking about modern day grocery in a shopping mall somewhere else. So you might have already seen such examples. One example I am taking it like this way. So the number of customer arriving at a grocery store, it can be modeled by a Poisson process with parameter lambda equal to 10 customer per hour. It is talking about expected number of arrival per interval length of the per interval. Okay, so expected, so 10 equal lambda equal to 10, that means it is talking about 10 customer per interval per hour. Whatever unit would be there, it is based on that. Okay, so this one is already given here, lambda is already given here. You have to model the Poisson process. This problem you have to model with the help of Poisson process. So it is talking about number of customer arrival at a grocery store. Okay, so this is the problem. So now here, what are the probability that we need to calculate? First, we need to calculate. We have to find what is the probability that there are two customers between 10 to 10 20. Okay, first question. Second question is that we have to find what is the probability that we observe three customers between 10 to 10 20 and seven customers between 10, 20 to 11. So here you can, here it is talking about a single event, here it is talking about two joint event. Here we are dealing with two non-overlapping interval. Here we are having only one interval, okay, 10 to 10, 20. Here we are having two intervals, so that is the problem. So two problem we are having, so we can calculate these two probability easily by assuming that this problem has been modeled by Poisson process. And lambda is already given here. Lambda is 10, and lambda is already 10. And interval, what is the interval between 10 to 10, 20? What? Okay, so it would be 1 by, so 10 to 20. So we have to convert it, talking about what is the interval length. Interval length is 20 minutes, but we are dealing unit in hour. So 20 minutes will be, what would be in term of hour? So we have to divide it by 60 in order to convert into hour. So in term of 60, it would be what? In term of hour, it would be interval length would be 1 by 3 hour. So interval length is 1 by 3 hour. Okay. And that if x is the number of arrival in that interval, then we can write that x as a Poisson distribution with what is the parameter? Parameter happens to be lambda time tau. Lambda is 10 and tau is 1 by 3. So that's the Poisson distribution parameter would be lambda time 10. That means lambda time tau. That means 10 times 1 by 3. So 10 times 1 by 3 is equal to 10 by 3. This is the parameter for this x. And the x and x happen a Poisson random variable. Now we will recall we are having parameter. We got the parameter. We are having number of customer. How many customer are arriving? Two customers. So that we denoted by k. K equal to what is the value of k? K equal to 2. So just we need to apply Poisson distribution for x equal to 2, and here lambda time tau equal to 10 by 3. So here remember that Poisson distribution parameter is lambda, and for Poisson in a Poisson process, a individual distribution random variable will have Poisson distribution lambda time tau, that length of the interval. Okay, so that's why e to the power lambda time tau will come e to the power minus 10 by 20 into lambda tau to the power k is equal to 2, so 10 by 3 to the power 2 divided by factorial k is what, equal to 2 factorial 2. If you calculate this number by using calculator, it is very a small number, so you can calculate after calculation it will come as 0.2. That means what is the probability that two customer is arriving between interval 10 to 10, 20 with this parameter. We can say that probability is 20%. 20% is the probability. 0.2 means 20%. You can convert that probability into percentage as well. Okay. Next question we'll solve it. Next question is talking about joint arrival. Joint arrival. So we are having two interval. One interval is 10 to 10, 20. So here in term of it is in term of minute. So it is tau. Interval length is 20 minutes, so you need to convert into hour. So 20 minutes would be means 1 by 3 hour. It is 1 by 3 hour. Okay, you can. So this call it tau 1, length of first interval, and it is equal to 1 by 3. So our unit here under consideration is what, hour. So that's everything we will measure in hour. Second interval is what is the length? It is going from 10:20 to 11. That means 40 minutes. Tau 2 is 40 minutes, length of the interval. So 40 minutes is what? It is equivalent to, in hour, it is equivalent to what? 2 by 3. So hour. 40 minutes is equivalent to 2 by 3 hour. So that is the interval length of second interval. Okay. 2 by 3 hour. So we are having everything, all information we are having. Now also it is already given how many arrivals it is already given. So it is given that there are 3 arrival in the interval, first interval, and 7 arrival in the second interval. And we know that it is a model by a Poisson process, and whatever arrival happening in non-overlapping interval, things happen to be independent. So that means if you want to calculate this joint probability, it would be product of individual probability. So product of probability of three arrival in interval 1 into 7 arrival, it would be 7 arrival in the interval 2. Okay, so if you calculate this probability again using the Poisson distribution, and what is for here for interval I1, what is the parameter? Parameter would be lambda time tau. That means lambda is already fixed, that one is equal to 10. And what is tau? Lambda times tau 1. Tau 1 is 1 by 3. So here this is the parameter. And for this interval, what is the parameter? It would be lambda time tau 2. So lambda time tau 2. Tau 2 is 2 by 3. So you can say that lambda time tau, it would be 20 by 3. And what is the Poisson distribution it is talking about? E to the power negative of parameter. What is the negative of lambda time tau? So what is that? That one is 20 by 10 by 3 into whatever parameter we are having, we have to raise it to the power how many arrival is happening there. So how many arrival happening in interval first interval I1? 3 arrival. So 3 arrival, and we have to divide this by factorial of number of arrivals, that 3, that means factorial of 3. So this is the probability, first probability, second probability would be e to the power, the lambda time tau 2 is what? 20 by 3. So 20 by 3 into 20 by 3 power of that will raise to up to what? It will raise up to 7. Number of arrival happening is 7, and we have to divide it by factorial 7. So after calculation of all these, what will happen if you simplify all these calculation would be 0.03. I have taken a rounding up to 2 decimal. Okay, so that means just it is talking about 3%. So there are 3% chance that three people will arrive in interval 1 jointly with 7 people in interval 2. So very less probability is coming like this way. Now in a Poisson process we are seeing interesting kind of scenario. What is that? Those things that similar things what we had already seen in case of Bernoulli process, that inter arrival time and arrival time. So it is very interesting that inter arrival time here time happens to be continuum in fashion. So inter arrival time will have continuous kind of distribution. So inter arrival time in case of Poisson distribution, it happens to be exponential in nature. Suppose nt, n is taken for notation for counting purpose. N is talking about always count, and how many things, n number of things. So that's why nt notation I have taken. So if nt is a Poisson process with the parameter lambda, with rate lambda, then inter arrival time x1 x2 up to it will go on like this way. Each xi happens inter arrival, so each interval wise it is happening in first interval number of arrival we denote it to inter arrival, that means first success, first arrival in the okay time till the first arrival. X1 is talking about time till the first arrival, X2 is talking about time till the first arrival after first time. Once we have seen one arrival, after that next first arrival, and X3 would be time till the next first arrival once you have already seen two arrival. So next, like that way. So these are xi. So if you observe xi, each xi happens to be exponential in nature. So you can see the plot like this way. In this interval 0 to t1, x1 is talking about, in this interval x1 is talking about first arrival, time of first arrival. Then once you have already observed first arrival, after that next, what is the time time for next first arrival? I am talking about x2 is talking about next first arrival when first arrival is already happened. So x2 is also x2 will take time between these two. So here at first, here at this point we observe first arrival, here we observe second arrival. So second arrival is actually what? It is the next first arrival after first arrival. So in that scenario x3 is again simply you can say that x3 is a next first arrival after two arrival has already occurred. So that's why x3 will take time between here. each xi, so each first arrival kind of say here time happens to be continuum in fashion. So each xi is what? Exponential in nature. And if someone is asking what is the distribution of this xi, it is exponential. And if it is exponential, then what is the mean value of each xi? So it's very easy to calculate the mean value of that xi can be written in term of lambda. So it would be 1 by lambda. And what is the variance? Variance would be also 1 by lambda square. It is very easy to calculate mean and variance of one exponential random variable. So that's where these things are very simple. And exponential is what? It is continuum version of geometric random variable. In case of Bernoulli process, we have already seen that inter arrival time is distributed geometrically. But again, if we observe in Poisson process, and here what you observe, the inter arrival time, it is distributed in exponential fashion. So that is the relation between Poisson process and Bernoulli process, we say that. So another thing that I will talk about arrival time. So once we are having inter arrival time, then just summing it through partial sum, we can define arrival time. So that means we are talking about total arrival in a particular in a specific interval. So how many arrivals happening? So like this way. So t1, if you are talking about in the first interval 0 to t1, so it is talking about first arrival. X1 is talking about first arrival, then X1, X2, you are taking together, then it is jointly these two are talking about two arrival. If you take some two arrival, so T2 is talking about two arrival in the interval, and Tn is talking about n arrival in that interval. So time of n arrival, Tn is talking about time of n arrival. So this Tn, you can say that these are partial sum of inter arrival time. So we know that each xi happens to be independent, while exponential, all these are exponential, and it's very easy to calculate. Due to that, it's very easy to calculate distribution of Tn. So distribution of Tn is what? It is gamma, and it is defined like the gamma distribution. It is defined like this way. And if you don't go like, don't worry about this structure of this gamma distribution. It is very simple. Similarly, what scenario we had discussed for arrival time for Bernoulli process, it was Pascal. It has been derived from geometric by taking two different scenario, and through that we had taken binomial construction. So binomial and sum is always defined. Sum of Bernoulli random variable happens to be binomial. In the same process, it is defined gamma. And here, we can easily calculate mean of this expectation of this Tn. How it is? We know that each xi happens to be independent, and each xi is having meaning mean 1 by lambda. So how many xi's are coming here in Tn? N number of. So we are summing that mean n times. So that's why n by lambda would be mean of Tn. And what would be variance? Variance also it would be n by lambda square, because each xi is having variance 1 by lambda square. So this is the scenario of arrival time, distribution of arrival time. Okay, and one more interesting feature we can see here in Tn is that it is not dependent. It is, sorry, not independent, it is dependent. There is a dependency between any two Ti's. You will see a dependency. That is the difference from arrival time of Bernoulli process. Now, I will talk about merging of two Poisson process. So one Poisson process N1 we are taking, and suppose it is having parameter lambda 1. Another Poisson process we are taking N2. That one is having that rate lambda 2. Then we can say that each xt, whatever xt will come, that random process, each xt, it is a what? Poisson process. Poisson distribution with parameter, what would be parameter of that? In Poisson, I am writing in short POIS. So Poisson parameter would be lambda 1 time tau. Or simply write it T. I have taken it T. So time interval T. So from that perspective, T take as a time interval, length of time interval. For this one, again, if you are taking second Poisson process with parameter lambda 2, then what would be distribution of each xt, each random variable for each t, what would be distribution? It would be Poisson distribution with the parameter lambda 2 time t. So Poisson with lambda 2 time t. Then what we do? We are merging these two processes together. Then if you are taking in any time interval t, what is the distribution of xt? So x distribution of xt would be given by here parameter would be would come as a summation of lambda 1 and lambda 2. So xt here in merge process it would be lambda 1 plus lambda t lambda 2 times the length of the interval, that one is t. So this is the merging process of two Poisson process. Similarly, we can go for a splitting. So taking one Poisson process, we can split into two different. The same criteria we can apply from Bernoulli process. How we did a splitting of a Bernoulli process, same thing you can apply here as well. So directly I am going to discuss about Markov chain. So here why we are going to discuss about Markov chain? Because there are some shortcomings in Bernoulli process and also in Poisson process. What are the shortcomings? You can observe that here we can say that in Bernoulli process each xi happens to be independent, each xn happens to be independent of past. There is independency. So it is independent of past. Past means x1, x2 up to xn minus 1. So that's why we can't go for universal modeling of real life problem. So definitely it always happens that if you take any evolutionary process, then future always depends. Many times you will observe that future depends on present. But if you go to model with Bernoulli process, then in Bernoulli process we observe that each any two member if you take, then there is a independency. So due to independency we can say that future is independent of present as well as past. So that's why Bernoulli process and Poisson process fail to model those problems which are having dependency of future on present or is on past. So if there is a dependency, then Markov process is playing very important role, because Markov process is satisfying Markov property. That's why name is Markov process is coming. So I had already taken a slide why need of Markov process or Markov chain. Simplest Markov process is Markov chain. Okay, so consider a discrete time random process xn. So in the very simple case where the xns are independent, in this case we can simply say that there is no memory, that future never depends on past. History is not going to influence your future. So each xn can be looked at independently from previous one. So there is no memory property, there is no dependency from past to future. So that's why each one can, you can go in a separate study. Okay, so however, if you go in a real life process, the independent assumption is not valid. Such as if you are taking xn is the stock price of a company at a particular time, and n, that n may be 0, 1, 2, 3, 5, then it is reasonable to assume that xn is xn's, that a stock price of future definitely it will depend on past. So it is very much obvious kind of things that future depends on past or present. Future depends on present, or through present it can depend on past as well. So dependency would be there. If you just observe dependency, you can't model a stock price with the help of Bernoulli process. Simply with the help of Bernoulli and Poisson process, you can't model a stock price, okay, of a company. So if you want to model, you have to go for Markov process. So therefore, we need to develop model where the value of past, you can call it future xn, it depends on the previous value, such as Markov chain. We can say that here Markov chain xn plus 1, that future value, it depends on present. It depends on present, but given present, it doesn't depend on the previous history. So in Markov chain is a very special kind of chain. It depends on present, but present is already given, and then future is independent of present. So that one is talking about directly Markov property. So it is Markov property. So you can simply, another way you can say that Markov chain depends on past through present. If present is, so this is, we can observe that this is condition on present, the random variable, future random variable, it is independent of past random variable, x0, x1 up to xn minus 1. So this is the very special Markov property. That means we need to observe condition probability like this way, conditional probability of xn plus 1, that means future given present xn. So this just we have to see this kind of scenario, this kind of probability. So it is like this way. It would be independent of history. It depends on present. So that is the Markov property. Further, we will see that Markov chain are usually used to model the evolution of a state in probabilistic system. So here a state scenario is coming. Different state will come. So those state are actually what? Those are actually value of the random variables associated with the corresponding random process. So more specifically, we can consider a system with set of possible state. These are actually a specific value of that. Those are value of the random variable. That random variable is taking. So range, so you can say that a state happen to be range of the random variables involved in the process. Okay, so suppose one example is that if xn equal to I, we say that the system is in ith state at time n. N is talking about time, that evolution, and I is talking about what value xn has taken. So you can say that that one is the state. So at time n, the random variable, the system is at a state I. So the idea behind Markov chain is summarized as, we can say that condition on the current state, the past and future are independent of each other. Past state and future state are independent. So suppose that we are modeling a queue. Suppose we are going to bank. In bank, now this queue system is very common. So you can suppose that we are modeling a queue at a bank. Then number of people in the queue is an it is a non-negative number. It is definitely, we can't say that negative people would be there, negative number of people. So definitely it would be a non-negative, some 0, 1, 2, 3 kind of things. So here the state of system is defined as the number of people in the queue. Okay, so in the queue, number of people, it will keep on varying. Sometimes you will observe that in queue there is 0 customer, or sometimes 1 or 1000 or 100 or something like that. So that number of people in that queue, it will keep on varying. So those scenario, you can say that those are actually a state, either one person in the queue or 2 person or 3. So that is the scenario at any time. So if xn solve the number of people in a queue at time n, then we can say that xn will take value, either it will take 0 or 1 or 2 or 3. So those are the value. Okay, so this set S, we are calling it a state space of the Markov chain. Okay, we are calling it so what are the value the random associated random variable will take, that we are calling it a state space of the Markov chain. Okay, so I will talk about definition of Markov chain now. Coming, so consider the random process xn, discrete kind of, so yeah, discrete time. I have taken discrete time. There is a continuous person as well, and there is a random process, discrete time random process, where the state space is 0 1 2. It will go on like this way up to what state you want to see. So we say that this random process is Markov chain if again I would like to say that xn and the xn plus 1, that means future state depends on present, depends on present, past, present and past through present only. So here we can say that present and past, everything is coming. So this probability is equal to this probability. That means we say that future, if present is given, then future depends on present only. It is not worrying about the past. So this probability is directly equal to this. That means it is not giving attention to past. It future depends on past, present. If present is given, then future. So whatever things are coming after this such that sign, that we are saying that it is given, it is a conditional probability. So we can say that if present is given, so then with given present, future is independent of past. So that's where these things are not playing much role in calculating this conditional probability, if future is present is given. So okay, further, if the number of state is finite, suppose your number of state is finite, there are r plus 1 state, so we will call in that case that Markov chain would be finite state Markov chain, or simply we can say that it is a finite Markov chain. So and if it is a finite Markov chain, then we need to introduce one transition probability. That means it is a probability that you are going from a state I to a state j. So that probability we denote it by Pij. It is talking about probability of transition from a state I to a state j. don't worry about this n, n plus 1, but these are just time index, so it may be anything. It may be anything, and this property we are calling it transition property, and that's the meaning of anything is that here this transition property from a state I to a state, focus on a state I, the transitioning happening from a state I to a state J. So a state I is your current state and a state J is your present state. At what time you are there, just don't worry about. So that's where this transition property, it happens to be independent of M. So that means the process, if the process is in a state I, it will next make a transition to future state J with what property? That property we are calling it Pij. Further, we can say that whether you go a state I to a state J from initial time to time 1, or whether you go for first time to second time, whether you go for n time to n plus 1 time, all those are irrelevant, all are having same transition property, that we are calling it Pij. So that is the beauty of this Markov chain or transition property. So if you are having transition property, I will talk about transition matrix. That transition matrix is what? It is a matrix where each entry is talking about transition property of one state to another state. So here I will talk about transition property. Suppose in a finite, so I am taking finite state Markov chain. So state number of state happen to be, that means individual associated random variable in this Markov chain are taking just a finite number of value. So that is the scenario. That means finite state Markov chain. And assuming that state happens to be 1, 2, 3, R, we are not taking 0 as well here. So then the state transition matrix, we can define it like this way. It is a matrix P11, first entry, it is talking about first row. It is talking about second row of transition matrix. It is talking about Rth row. So it is R by R transition matrix. Okay. So you can observe in very interesting property is that if you sum the this transition property row wise, the summation would be equal to 1. So it is satisfying. So one distribution is defining, one row is defining one distribution, another row is defining another distribution like that in that scenario. So normal, simply it is equivalent to normalizing condition. So this transition matrix is satisfying this condition. We will see one example later. So this is because given that we are in a state I, the next state must be one of the possible states. So if suppose we are in a state I, then next state would be one of the possible states. That means it is counting from a state 1. So first row is counting that from a state 1. Wherever you want to go, you can go. So if you sum up, so with different probability, you are going different state from the given state. Suppose first state, you are in first state. In first state, you may go this side, 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 like this way. So and then going from this state to another next state, that whether this one is feature state, this one is feature state, all these are feature state. So if you sum all these properties, definitely there would be transition property. So some property would be here, some property, something would be here, something would be here, something would be here, something would be here. If you sum it up all, then summation would be always equal to 1. So if you are fixing one state and you are jumping from that state to another state, then that transition or jump probability will be equal to 1. So that is the scenario. Okay. So it is talking about, if you suppose this one is 1, so it is talking about first row. If you are taking a state 2, then it will talk about second row, likewise Rth row. So that is the scenario. Okay. Thus we when we sum over all the possible value of k, we should get, that's way what I discussed it here. So that would be equal to 1. And that is the row of any state transition matrix, it must be equal to sum of rows of any state transition matrix, it must be equal to 1. Why? It is talking about all possible transition from a given state. Okay. So now next we are having a transition matrix. I will talk about how we can, that one is very algebraic approach if you are dealing with transition matrix. So what is the geometric approach? So geometric approach of transition properties, all collection of transition properties from a state is that we are calling it transition diagram. So I will talk about transition diagram. What does it talk about? Say a Markov chain is usually it can be shown by a state transition diagram. So we consider a Markov chain with three possible very simple kind of Markov chain I have taken where there are only three states, and these are the following transition matrix. So transition matrix is already given. This is the transition matrix. This is the transition matrix of the given Markov process with three states. So that's why 3 by 3 transition matrix we will get it here. Okay, this you can easily see that it is a 3 by 3 transition matrix. Now, various question is coming. So then transition diagram with these three possible state and the corresponding transition probability will denote it as corresponding transition probability will denote it as arrow from whichever state present state I it would be and where you are going to other state J. So there would be arrow from present state to future state. So present state happens to be I and present future state happens to be J. So that probability, transfer probability will be denoted by arrow and value of that is given by Pij. And if there is no arrow between any two state, then simply we will say that the transfer probability is zero. So that means with the help of this given transfer probability matrix, how we can define a transition diagram. So transition, so you can observe that there are three states, state 1, state 2, state 3. So here we can observe that this one is talking about P11, that means you are in state 1 and from state 1 you are going to state 1 itself. So what is that probability? That probability is 1 by 4. So you can observe that you are going state 1 to 1 itself. So with what probability? That, what is the transfer probability? Transfer probability is 1 by 4. Then this one is talking about P12. That means from state 1 you are going state 2 and what is that probability? That probability is 1 by 2. So that means where is state 2? This is state 2. So from 1 you are going to, so this is the arrow it is talking about transition from state 1 to state 2 with what probability? It is 1 by 2. Okay, now next it is talking about P13. So it is talking about from state 1 you are going state 3 with what probability? 1 by 4. So where is state 3? This is state 3. So you can observe that with probability 1 by 4 you are going from state 1 to state 3. Similarly, if you go to talk about this entry is what? P21. So P21 is what? It is talking about transition from state 2 to 1. So with what probability? It is going with probability 1 by 3. Similarly, if you see, observe, what is this one? This entry is talking about P22. That means transition from the state to itself. We observe there is no transition from state 2 to itself. That's why value is 0. There is no transition from state 2 to itself. So that's why probability is 0. Now, similarly, we can observe that there is a transition from state 2 to state 3 with what probability? 2 by 3. So you can observe that probability 2 by 3. This is the probability 2 by 3. So all these are probabilities. So same transition matrix you can convert into this kind of graph that we are calling it diagram, transition diagrams. It is very easy to visualize things, transition activity in the transition diagram. So it is a homework again, try to see all these entries of transition matrix in the form of transition diagram. Okay. Now, I will wind up this course just with three questions. First question that find what is the probability that your transition is happening from state 2 to state 3. So you don't bother about this time. So just look here, what is the probability that you are going from state 2 to state 3. So what is the probability? 2 by 3. So this probability is directly equal to 2 by 3. This probability directly you can calculate 2 by 3. Next, if you are having a transition diagram, easily you can calculate all the relevant probability. So next probability that what is the probability that you are in a state 1 and from a state 1 you are going to a state 1 in one transition. So you can see that this is present time is 2 and future time is 3. That means you are taking 1 minute from 2 to 3. That means one transition is happening. And what is that probability? That probability is 1 by 4. In one transition you are going from state 1 to itself, that probability is what? 1 by 4, equal to 1 by 4. Next question is that if suppose initial probability is already given, that initially you are in state 1, initial time, this 0 is always talking about initial time, with probability 1 by 3, and then you have to find what is the probability that, joint probability that at initial time you are at 1 and at next time, jump is happening and next time you are at 2, state 2. So this probability just apply what theorem? You apply multiplication theorem or chain rule. So this joint probability you can write it like this way. You can introduce conditioning. So conditioning over x naught. So it would be x2, x1. Suppose 2 is your future time. So at the time, future time, future 2 is future state and future time is 1. So at future time you are in second state given, present state is 0, initial state is you present given x 0 equal to and present state is what 1 into what property will come x of 0, property that x of 0 equal to present x of 0 that present at present time you are at present state 1. This property. So we it is all. So what is this property? This property you can get it from transition diagram. That means you are transition is happening from a state 1 to a state 2. That property is what 1/2. That property is 1/2. And initial property of being in a state 1. That one is already given. What is that property? That property is 1/3. So this joint property you can see that this joint property is equal to 1/6. So you got the answer 1/6. Similarly, you can calculate second property, this property, this joint property. That means it is talking about three state. It is talking about three state. So three state are coming together. So you have to apply that conditioning approach. First, take conditioning like this way. Suppose x zero is happening first. So p of x0 at initial time you are in initial state 1, then what you are going next state, what is that next state would be what second state. So at next time that means x1 equal to 2 given x0 equal to at initial time you are in first state time what would come into next state is 3, then x at time x2 we are in state 3 given x0 equal to 1 and x1 equal to 1. So like this way, this is just chain rule kind of thing is coming. So you can calculate all these properties. So every property you can calculate from transition diagram. And finally, you will get the result. So likewise, you can go for multiple state, n state. You can go and apply, keep on applying chain rule, and you will get your desired probability. Whatever probability question would be associated with that state transition diagram, you can calculate every probability. Okay. So okay, any question? If you are having, you can ask that question. Otherwise, I.